Welcome to those who wait, and you guys have been so patient. It's finally game time here. Game number two of a packed day of Group B action. Shout out to everybody out on Twitch, YouTube, and the ESPN app. It is Drini and Mo, and it's going to be Mo on offense first. As I mentioned, using those Dallas Cowboys, the same team he won in regs, using that team with the Madden Classic, where you know, all he did was walk away with a belt. Tie for Mo. This first drive, especially as a runner, seems like a good opportunity to set the tone.
Yeah, definitely. I think we're going to see Mo go through so many different formations. You might see him in a random formation every time. I think Mo is at a disadvantage. Like, it's well documented. Mo is one of the best offline, in-person players. He's not one of the better online players, so he's going to have. It's going to be about adjustments for him. He's going to kind of test out what Drini's doing and then adjust from there.
First down and 10 for Mo with Aaron Rodgers at the quarterback position. He's going to drop back to pass to start this game, and he throws it right to Drini. That's not the right team. Young Drini's into the end zone. Mo can't believe he threw a touchdown on the first play. Unfortunately, it was to the wrong side.
And Drini just with a little smirk saying, Mo, you can't give me that. That's way too easy. Drini Joker, the double champ, the TikTok master, starting the game off 7-0. That's too easy for Drini.
How about this? We have four players in this group. Every single player has matched up with every other player. So we have history. Mills has played Mo. Mo has played Kiv. Drini, of course, has played Kiv. The only pairing that has not played each other before in an MCS event, Mo and Drini. First time we get to see this one. And it starts off on the right foot for Drini as he finds himself with a touchdown to start off the game on the defensive side of the ball. And why don't we take a look at that Snickers touchdown replay, TD. This is just straight up a lurk.
Yeah, just try to go to that slant post combo and Drini all over it. Ed Reed, easy lurk. The easiest touchdown Drini will ever be given on a big stage like this.
Ed Reed has the longest interception return in NFL history at 107 yards. That one just a little shorter than that 107-yarder he had against the Eagles. Second down and 8. Rodgers gets stuck trying to hand the ball off. It slowed down the entire animation. He ends up picking up nothing.
Yeah, Mo looking a little frazzled on offense. Mo did tweet out today he's definitely going 0-3, but I think that was kind of a little sarcasm from Mo. I know he's always confident in his game, especially on the defensive side of the ball. And like you said earlier, Nick, this is a dream matchup to most. They've never matched up before. Two of the best players we've ever seen in competitive Madden, and as a nice dot right there to John Ross.
He also tweeted out yesterday that Voltrax was going 3-0, so maybe he'll be wrong again as that pass, little corner route to the left side, and see, Mo giving a little shake of the head. He knows this is not the start that he wanted, and maybe that pass settles him down a little bit. So we are on the second drive of the game. I almost said first, but that first drive went by so quickly. One play, one touchdown the wrong way. Aaron Rodgers into that I formation. Two wide receivers split to the left. And it's going to be Gale Sayers taking the carry. And once again, Drini showing off that run defense.
Drini in that 3-4 pinch run defense, a lot of cover two actions. One of the best run defenses in the game this year. I want to see Mo kind of get to the outside with that Gale Sayers versus staying in the strong close. He's going to audible around. You saw him in that I-form close slot, I-form twins. As you can see here, he's looking for something to go to.
I think the one formation you probably won't see is you're not going to see a lot of shotgun five wide from Sirius Mo. He's going to be under center and showing the ability to pound the rock. We're going to establish the run game. It's Sayers right side, and Sayers has some room, and he cuts back inside, and there goes Gale Sayers to the house. Right, Sirius Mo winding and weaving like a mountain road, and he's got an extra point to tie this game up.
Great stick work by Sirius Mo. That little cutback was just enough, and he's able to break off a big run and get back in this ball game. Great drive to bounce back by Sirius Mo.
We love to say when Bo Jackson's on the field that Bo knows. Well, guess what? Mo knows too. He knows exactly where the end zone is. 7-7, and for the first time, we're going to get to see Drini's offense come back out on the field. What a run from Gale Sayers. Let's take a look at this one more time. He gets to the second level, but Ty, he had to show off a little stick to get past the user.
Yeah, just a little patience right there, a little stop and go to the inside. Nice stick work by Mo, and that was a big drive for Mo. You know, his confidence probably went down after that. I mean, the first play of the game through a pick six probably felt horrible. So for him to, and he's not known for his offense, so him to come back, get that easy touchdown right there on that run is definitely huge for him.
Sirius Mo, also known as the happiest player in the game of Madden, showing that off with that beautiful grin he's got. Drini on offense for the first time. And what are we looking for from Drini on offense, Ty? Because you look at his abilities, it seems like he's going to be fairly balanced.
Yeah, he's very balanced. He's got that hard route master, so that'll be huge for him. We're going to see him in a lot of different formations. You know, he likes the gun tight slots. He'll audible to some jet touch passes out of spread. He'll go down to these I-form strong formations. He really built a balanced team, so you don't really know what's coming from him, and that's the beauty of how Drini plays. He's very controlled, very balanced. He's basically just going to keep going until he finds something that you can't beat, that you can't stop.
Spent 686 cap on defense, 501 on offense, and he has players spread all about. 91 Eli Manning at quarterback, and he's got the 98 Gale Sayers at halfback, the ability to pass and run, and he's going to run first, and that's Gale Sayers, and Sirius Moe should know the power that Gale Sayers has. He'll pick up 19 on first down.
Yeah, just a basic little halfback dive from strong close, some bad stick work by Moe. He's got to know better than that, trying to go for that hit stick, and a big gain right there for Drini.
See Sirius Moe using with the Carolina Panther, Dante Jackson, Taylor Mays, handoff to Sayers up the middle. And look who is in the thick of it, Troy Polamalu bringing down Sayers.
Drini is one of the guys that I know. There's not many guys in Madden that spend more time in practice mode labbing than Drini Joka. He has a beater. He knows every run that beats every defense. I mean, this guy's a mastermind at that stuff. And you can guarantee he's been in the lab knowing this 3-4 defense is coming, and he's had success on those first couple plays with the dive.
Two wide receivers out there for Drini as Manning drops back to pass on second and 9. And he's got Evan Engram, and Evan Ingram's got enough space. He looks like NASA out there into the end zone one time for young Drini.
Two of the easiest touchdowns to start a game for Drini. I mean, the first play of the game, a pick six, and then no one even 10 yards from Evan Engram on that post route. Another easy touchdown for Drini. Moe, you know, really selling out for the run, and Drini takes advantage.
I know it is shocking to say, but if you look at me on camera, it doesn't look like I have a lot of speed, and I think I could have made it to the end zone with that much room out there. It's 14-7, points galore, and we're not even at the end of the first quarter yet. We take a look at this one more time. How did Engram get so open?
Yeah, I mean, Moe had to go worry about that wheel route. That wheel route would have been a touchdown as well. No one was over there, and then that post just became naked. Just bad defense by Moe. Really no other way to explain it.
It's never good when you have to go guard a route that would have been a touchdown and give up a touchdown on the other side. It's a lose-lose situation as Moe comes back out on offense. First down and 10, and it's Gale Sayers right side. Just got held up by Ed Reed. He'll still pick up a couple and bring up a second and 7.
That could have been a huge play as well. You know, it's really crazy right now because these guys are both known for their defense, not so much their offense. And the way this game is going so far, like, besides that pick six, I mean, it looks like they have anything they want on offense, both guys. I mean, these runs look like they can be broken for a big gain anytime.
I think they saw that first game went 6-0, and they went, listen, we'll help you guys out. We'll put some offense on the board. As Sayers outside, trying to find some room. He'll pick up 3, slow and steady, wins the race for Sirius Moe.
Yeah, had a lot of space out there as well, but pretty good tackle right there by Drini. Now a big 3rd and 4 here. Moe might think about punting if he doesn't convert this. 4th and 1, I think he'll go for it, but let's see what the call is. I think he'll stick to the ground game here on 3rd and 4.
Into that I formation, Gale Sayers at the top of the I, 2 wide, split wide left. That's Hollywood Brown and John Ross, plenty of speed. As Sayers, a little juke move, tries to get to the edge, and Drini's defense, Ed Reed able to bring down Sayers and sets up a 4th and short.
Oh boy, he had a lot of space out there, kind of got tripped up. That could have been a big play, and now it's decision time for Sirius Moe. 4th and 1 on your own 32. I think he's going to go for it.
Oh, we only had 6 points in our first game in Group B. We got 21 in the first quarter here. If you like offense, you're going to love this game. It's 14-7. Drini on top, and Moe with a key 4th and 1, and he has the offense on the field. Sayers at the top of the eye. Aaron Rodgers under center, barking out orders. Could be a big momentum play early in this game. Stretch run right side. Sayers trying to get to the line. Lattimore stands him up. Oh, the defense from Drini stands tall.
What a tackle by Drini. I mean, it looked like he had the edge. He got the best animation you can get for a secure tackle right there. Wow, big stop for Drini. Now he's in complete control.
And with great field position at the 32-yard line. So Drini right now ahead, 2 stops on Sirius Moe. One was a pick six, and right there on 4th and 1, he gets his 2nd stop of the game already. 1st and 10 for Drini's offense. got John Ross now in motion from right to left. It's going to be a handoff to Gale Sayers, trying to find some room outside, and that swarming defense from Sirius Moe says, hold on a second, young fella.
Goes back to the halfback dive, and young Drini Joka, $277,000 in career MCS earnings, which is insane. Number two all-time, looking to add on to it, the defending Madden Bowl champion, going back to that I-form close.
Crazy part about that, he's second all-time to Michael Skimbo, and he's only done that in 3 years. It's not like he's had the, wasn't playing in Madden 16, wasn't playing in Madden 17. As Manning drops back on second and 11, looking left side, and Sirius Moe says thank you because Drini gave him a gift wrap Christmas present. Oh, it may be May, but it's looking like Christmas out there.
Wow, he got a terrible animation on that throw right there. Drini very upset. Looked like he highballed it, but I don't think he did. He should have probably lowballed that. Moe able to click on, make a big pick, and now Moe's back in the game. That could be the boost that Moe needed.
14-7, and Moe gets his first stop of the game with an interception. He's all the way back on his own 14-yard line, though. He's got a long way to go before he can tie this one up. Two wide receivers out there out of that I formation. Expect another run from Sayers. He's actually had some success passing the ball, though, out of these under center formations. We saw a nice little corner out to pick up a third down. Sayers running left side, a little spin move. Gave him the old washing machine and picks up a couple.
Drini very sound on defense right now. Besides that one run that Moe got for a touchdown, he hasn't had much going on. You're going to have to see Moe, you know, go to the air a little bit more here, mix in some of these passes. I think we're going to start to see him do that, start to get that freestyling going on that we know Moe is known for.
So he's now into that strong eye formation. He's going to drop back to pass with Aaron Rodgers rolling right side, throwing back left to the tight end Ingram. And here's the interesting development of this game, Ty. We're seeing with these two utilizing Evan Ingram, the tight end position has been largely forgotten in salary cap and it's starting to pick up a little steam.
Very important, especially when you're in these under-center formations and you want to be balanced. You want to have some pass plays you can go to, and that tight end is so important as he runs a little zone there. But to your point, Nick, that tight end is so important in these formations. You're going to see a lot of posts. You're going to see a lot of corner routes. Right there, he went with that slant post combo. Drini bit on the slant just for a second. Moe recognized that great patience. He's able to hit the post for a big play.
Yeah, Evan Ingram out of Ole Miss, two-time All-SEC tight end, 12 touchdowns. In three seasons with the New York Giants. They're just hoping that guy can stay healthy. Second and seven, Rodgers. He'll throw it right up the middle, and who else but Evan Ingram using every bit of his 6'3", 240 frame to catch that in front of the defense.
Great read right there by Moe. That's one of the most popular routes in Madden 20, that delayed tight end fade route. He was very patient, waited for it, released it, and able to pick up a big first down with the possession catch.
First and 10. At the 50-yard line, Moe's put together a nice drive that started all the way back at the 14 off the interception. He's hoping this will be the last drive of the half as Drini will get the ball to start the second half. And how about in the gap right there? The tackle from Drini. And now, don't adjust your television set. That was Calvin Johnson, the former wide receiver, making an appearance on defense.
99 overall, Calvin Johnson, safety. Drini's got him at linebacker here, and Drini's run defense has been exceptional so far. Moe looks like he's going to go back to the air, try to make something happen.
2 minute warning in the first half, 14-7, as Rodgers back to pass, read all over the tight end, but he leaves him to guard the underneath route, and Moe says, all right, you leave Evan Ingram, I'll hit him one more time. I don't need to pass to anybody else.
Super impressed with Moe's passing plays so far on this drive. He went with that post-hitch combo, playmaker the hitch back. Drini had to bite on that. He's able to hit the post on the sideline. Kind of a, you know, tight window, but he's able to get it in there for a big play.
You go back to Gale Sayers, and once again, what is Drini doing defensively against the run? It seems like there's no room for Sayers to even get back to the line of scrimmage.
He's really sealing the edge well. He's not allowing Gale Sayers to get outside on these stretches, on these off tackles, on these power O's. Drini's doing a really nice job on that. He's doing pretty good on the dives as well. Moe going to go back to the air again. That's all he's got right now.
It's Rodgers back to pass. He'll throw it to Sayers. Listen, if I can't get the run game going, let's try to get him some yards out of the backfield. He'll pick up two, which is technically more than the yard he lost running the ball on first down.
This is a chess match going on right now between two of the best ever. Drini decides to dial up the blitz. Moe recognizes it right away, hits the flats, but he's not able to get much. And now a big third down for Moe. Let's see what he can cook up here. He's going to run the ball, yeah.
Wow. And there is the run and the spin move back inside to pick up the first down. Showing off a little stickiness from Sirius Moe. Can he get a little closer to the monitor? I'm not sure he can see that well.
And that's what Moe does. He's very tricky. A third and 10, a very passable situation. He goes to run the ball, catching Drini off guard for a big first down. That's the type of things that Moe will do to you. He's the freestyle master for a reason.
14-7. As we're nearing the end of the first half, Moe got that interception. He's used almost this entire clock on this drive. He's been doing it with a mix of running and passing. We'll see the pass here as Rodgers is back. Waiting, looking. Nobody open. Nobody open. Nobody open.
Great defense right there by Drini. You heard Moe just say good defense, and it really was. He bit on the slant, and then he came back on that delayed fade that Moe loves, and now we got another big third down.
Spent 42 cap on his quarterback, Aaron Rodgers, the best release in Madden 20. So good value at the quarterback position, 88 overall. Former Cal Golden Bear, third down and 9. I wonder if he'll be looking over his shoulder at Jordan Love this season. As he hands it to Sayers, a stretch run. And Calvin Johnson, man, should Calvin have been playing defense this whole time? He's really wrapping up with that secure tackler.
Yeah, that secure tackler, huge. Calvin Johnson been huge for Drini, and a big stop right there, forcing Moe to kick 3. We're going to have a 14-10 game going into the half, man. This is a battle. This is exactly what we expected from these two legends.
It was fireworks in the first quarter. We had 21 points on our first 3 drives, but since then the defenses have settled down a little more surgical. And as there are zeros on the clock, it is 14-10 heading to the third quarter. And, you know, Ty, it doesn't feel like either one of these guys has an edge.
No, it doesn't. Drini going to get the ball up 4, so he does have a little bit of an advantage. Getting that, holding Moe to 3 right there in the last drive was pretty big. But like you said, yeah, both these guys, you know, no one's really taking advantage. Both guys have been impressive. You know, besides that first pick, there hasn't really been a lot of mistakes.
Well, it is halftime, second game of the day here in Group B. It was a couple interceptions deciding the first half, 14-10. Drini on top over Sirius Moe, but we still have 10 minutes to play. Guys, make sure you head over to the Madden Competitive Gaming channel on YouTube for access to each and every match for the Madden NFL 20 Bowl, as well as every match from this Madden Championship Series season. Make sure to subscribe as we update throughout the week during group play at the Bowl. The Madden Competitive Gaming YouTube channel is the official home for VODs of all the best matches throughout the year. That's the Madden Competitive Gaming channel on YouTube, where Madden Competitive lives. 14-10 is our score as we take a look at prize earnings here at the Madden Bowl. He's number 2 all time, and he is number 1 by a long mile over Young Kiv. And Ty, that just shows how effective he has been in his short career.
Oh, man, that just shows how consistent. Every tournament, you got to think Drini's a favorite. $277,500 at 20 years old. What's he even doing with that money? I hope he's investing it for the future. That is a lot of money, Nick.
No, he's investing it in his TikTok career, I'm pretty sure. As we head to the second half of action back inside Pizza Hut Stadium, you want to talk about consistency. He has had 8 major appearances. In 6 of them, he has placed in the top 5. In 5 of them, he has been first or second. And this is a young man who is not even 21 years old as Gale Sayers picks up 6.
Yeah, Drini, he's never going to wow you with anything on offense. He's really good on defense, but he's just very solid on offense. You know, like we said, he's very balanced. He's about 50-50 as far as runs and passes. He's going to find something to beat you, and he's just going to do enough. He's going to take his field goals when he needs to. He's just never going to beat himself, and that's the reason he always gets to the end of these big tournaments.
Born and raised in the D.C. area, said he's been labbing with Bugs, Clef, Ghost, Rage, said he wanted to shout out the whole Joka family, Kratobin, Strafen, Prodigy. I mean, he really dove into the Madden community and found a wide array of lab partners coming into the Madden Bowl. 3rd and 3, it's Sayers with the carry, and Sayers just stood up. How about Jerome Baker in there for the hit? And Drini's going to hurry back to the line, trying to catch Moe off guard with a hurry-up offense. Eli Manning in the shotgun. 2 wide to the right side, 1 over to the left side. Evan Engram, the tight end, also on the left side of that formation. Can Moe get a major stop to start off this second half over the middle? John Ross, possession, catch, money.
What a sequence of events. A big stop by Mo, and then a clutch stop by Drini right there. He had the halfback wheel, flat combo on the wide side. Then he went with the post on the backside. Mo bit on the wheel. Post was wide open. Just great execution by Drini. Mo very upset.
And Ty, Drini said one of his keys was making his opponent come out in a bad pass defense and make them pay. And right there, that hurry up got Mo on his heels.
Yeah, I think he saw something he liked, hurried up to the line, hiked it pretty quickly, and able to get a big first down in the game.
Back to Gale Sayers, back to that ground and pound attack, picking up four, seven carries, 29 yards, averaging just over four carries so far. It's not the flashy 14 and a half we saw from Joke yesterday, but every one of those runs is effective and does keep Sirius Mo guessing defensively, as back to the line is Drini. And back to the ground is Sayers, and he'll be sitting on the ground as look at that insta blitz to get Gale Sayers down and give back all that he gained.
Drini handed it off to the wrong side. He's got a righty quarterback. You always want to hand those dives off to the right. And Clowney just comes through untouched, clean. And now it's a big down right here. Sirius Mo has got to get off the field. That last fourth down, he couldn't do it. Can he hold him here on this big third and 10?
Coming out with 3-3-5 defense. Trying to match up against this.